I worked at KingsIsle for 7 years before I touched Wizard101. It was like, okay, no pressure, wrap up this whole thing now, you get to finish. And it was like, oh, okay. I have a wonderful team of writers. And so we got together and we brainstormed some stuff, and that was Imperia, that was the end of Arc 3.
So the favorite piece of art that I personally worked on before I became a director was the Marleybone hub. Because when I was working on it, I was able to put a bunch of Easter eggs in it for all my friends and family. I was just having a lot of fun working on Wizard.
I mean, it's magical. There's not a better word for it. It's magical. It's interesting watching players who grew up playing Wiz, the changing relationship that they have with the game as adults. As a designer, we look at things like the grind, like how much time should players spend to get these things? And a lot of these things, it's not a big deal for kids. They're going back to that combat over and over. And as an adult, it's just a different perspective, right?
Don't feel rushed, man.
Was that not specific enough?
No. I'll be here.
He doesn't like the fact that he
has a... That's awesome.
I joined 16 years ago as an associate producer. I came out halfway across the country to an unknown game that I didn't even know what I was making. I could tell that anybody of any age would have fun playing it, but I was, in my late 20s at the time, and I was hooked.
My journey to where I am now is a very, very long story, but it started in 2013 when I saw a commercial for Wizard101 on the TV. I was a sophomore in high school at the time. I was interested, so I decided to download and play the game, and then I fell in love with it instantly.
Back in the day, it was just the first day that we launched Friends and Family Alpha, just being able to get people in, seeing our hard work, seeing all the cool things that the team's created, and watching them experience that for the first time was just super, super cool.
I'll try my best.
Okay, oh man, these are ones that I probably should have prepared for.
That went by fast.
Wow.
I like it.
We've hired a lot of new people into the company in the past few years, and it has brought a new level of energy. Most of the people that we've been hiring on have actually been players of the game as children and have grown up, gone to college, graduated college, and now are here working on the games they love.
One of the things also that was not predicted when Wizard first shipped was the degree to which parents and even grandparents were going to play this game. You can tell on the forums that, oh, that clearly is a person in college. Oh, that clearly is a parent. Oh, that clearly is someone, you know, within the age range listed on the box. And yeah, man, we've had people playing for a decade who are now in college.
I loved that there was a sense of community, that I could get to know really welcoming people and kind of create this time for myself that was really fun outside of real life, outside of my homework and school responsibilities, which was really, really cool. So I quested up my wizard. I interacted with a lot of people outside of the game, on forums, on fan sites, and I met a lot of really, really cool new people. And through that, I started to help other people. I started to make guides. I started to guest star on videos. Anything that I could help kind of share my knowledge about, that's what I did.
Originally, I had intended to be a social studies teacher. I very deliberately put in lots of historical references, lots of little things. If I can convince a player to read one book that they would not have otherwise read, you know, to see one movie that they would not otherwise have seen, and, you know, alter their mind that much, then I have succeeded in my goal, you know, and I'm still being an educator almost.
One of the coolest things about working here is that I think I have, I mean, I'm biased, but I think I have one of the best art teams in the industry. I would put my art team up against any art team out there. I think they're incredible.
Mouths move now, and eyes move now, and art has gone out of their way to make more talk animations. And so suddenly, you know, whereas 15 years ago, it was a guy standing there, you know, with a little thing that would pop up. And now, you know, you can zoom in on him. You can zoom out. While he's talking, you can zoom to what he's talking about and then come back to him. So that, I think, from within my discipline, has been the biggest add since the game originally launched.
I guess what I really like about it is just the passion of the game's advocates, or the company's advocates, right?
But I think one of the coolest things is there are some amazing artists that are just, you know, they work behind the scenes and you would never know it. They do it because they love the artwork and they love the game. Jesse Slade. There's Jeff Tony, and Jeff does Abracadoodle. He kind of created the kind of doodle style.
And that's what's so cool about having community members on the team, or Gary, who was in team, you know, went the other way as a team member and then becomes a strong community member. They have a lot of strong emotional passion and fire for the game. And I love it because, you know, you kind of want to follow that.
Adam shares his, like, you know, not only he has his personal work and stuff that he shares, but he'll, you know, often once we get things put out and it's in public eye, he can share a lot of his concept work that we've done. And we also have other artists that do it as well. I know that I think Tony Gaddis is plugged into the community, you know, pretty well.
Like whether it comes out of the community and the community, if the community's really, if there's like a surge of interest in this thing, you know, you want to go there. Or like, you know, when Gary comes up and he's super excited about something he wants to do, I'd love to have him do it, you know? I love to enable him to do it. So that's what's cool. I've got names, I'll name names.
I'm just trying to figure out where I want to start it out at.
Whatever, walk into the fear.
Favorite character, that's tough.
Besides Cyrus, or Ratbeard, I guess, for sure.
Actually, yeah, I have it.
El Toro's good too.
It's got it in here.
Cyrus, Drake, Myth Professor.
So my favorite character is the Fennec Foxes.
I think I'm partial to Thalmea for, you know, reasons.
I like Thalmea because I have to like Thalmea.
Like, I don't know why. They're just awesome.
But if you were going to ask, I really like Dworgen.
I would say Bartleby is my favorite non-professor character, just because he's kind of like your door into the greater spiral.
I really like Zeke. I love the Zeke quests. I think they're hilarious.
In Wizard, I'm very fond of Grandmother Raven.
Each one has that, you know, band name built into the quest, and that you go find the thing about the band. So I've always enjoyed Zeke, and I love that he travels to every world with you.
You quite literally enter Krakatopia through Bartleby, through the spiral door, and I think that's one of the most memorable parts of the beginning of the game.